What is diabetes self-management training, and how can a pharmacist use it to bill for their services? Find out next. Hi, I'm Blair Thielemeyer, and I work with pharmacists who want to build and grow their clinical consulting services. Today, I want to talk to you about diabetic self-management training, also known as DSMT. So the first thing we need to talk about is DSMT is an education training program for newly diagnosed diabetics. Most of these are Medicare beneficiaries. They can also be Medicaid in certain states. So if you're in a state that their Medicaid program pays for DSMT, you could look at becoming an accredited provider and be able to provide that in a community pharmacy. So many community pharmacies are providing DSMT services, especially in group type settings. So eligibility, as I mentioned, is newly diagnosed diabetics. For the newly diagnosed, they're eligible for 10 hours of self-management training in their first year. In subsequent years, they're eligible for 2 hours per year. So those are billed using the G codes 0108 as an individual, and that is 30 minutes per code billed, and then 0109 for a group session for 30 minutes. So say you're going to do a supplement, a second year subsequent billing visit, and the patient has been diagnosed in a previous year, and you're offering the second year of training. You can bill that G0109 for the 30 minutes in a group session 4 times in that calendar year. So whether it's diabetic self-management training or medical nutrition therapy, which we'll talk about in a later video, Medicare does require documentation to be provided that shows that the patient has been diagnosed through one of the following: fasting blood sugar, A1C, or 2-hour postprandial glucose. So the patient has to be seen by the provider. It has to be documented that they are diagnosed as a diabetic and this documentation provided, and then receive a referral to the DSMT training center. So the criteria to provide DSMT programs is, as I just mentioned, the order must be written by a physician stating the patient needs DSMT training. They also must have an accreditation with the ADA or the AADE, so the program material and the site offering the education must be accredited. Used to, you would have to be a certified diabetic educator to offer these trainings, but that is not the case anymore. As long as the site is accredited by one of these accrediting bodies, then you can provide DSMT through the organization. So to be a part of this accredited training, the providers do need to have 15 hours of diabetes-related continuing education training each year. Once you gain accreditation status, even as a community pharmacy, you need to notify your local MAC. Remember, MAC stands for Medicare Administrative Contractor, and your state's Medicaid programs, showing them your accreditation so that you can get set up to bill. And then the last point to remember is about billing. So if you're being set up to bill under a organization name, you also have to make sure that you're billing under the organizational MPI. If you're set up to bill under a private provider practitioner's name, you have to bill using that practitioner's MPI. So the MPI host and the accrediting organization that is doing the billing have to be the same. So how can a clinical consultant pharmacist use this code? Well, we're seeing many pharmacies across the nation applying for DSMT accreditation. Once you get accredited, or in collaboration with a local provider, you can start getting referrals from patients into the program. This opens up additional revenue sources and also establishes a very deep collaborative connection with the local provider in your area. The ADA and different websites have great sample referral and marketing forms that you can use to go out and market DSMT services to providers in your area. There are specific rules that apply to certain provider clinics, like for example, an FQHC. DSMT for an FQHC can be provided, but it has to be provided in the individual one-to-one basis. So just to give you an idea on some reimbursement rates for an FQHC, the 2017 prospective payment system rate for for DSM training would be about $163 of reimbursement. And remember, just like the diabetes prevention programs we talked about previously, such as remote patient care monitoring and the National Diabetes Prevention Program, if you're doing activities such as monitoring glucose, monitoring activity, monitoring patient's weight, you can use other codes such as remote patient care monitoring codes along with these DSMT services. So if this video was helpful to you, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and share it with a colleague. And if you'd like more information on billing for pharmacist-led clinical services, join the Pharmapreneur Community Newsletter. It's at btpharmacyconsulting.com/newsletter.